thank you Jen and thank you Hairil. Good evening to Chief Minister of Penang, Saudara Lim Guan Eng, MP for PJ Otara, Saudara Tony Pua, Adun Subang Jaya Hanayo, and Chong Chien Ren, MP for Bandar Kuching, Saudara Sanjan, and also MPHA councillors, Saudara Pui Wen Kiong and Saudara George Yap. Ladies and gentlemen, 各位嘉宾们，大家晚上好。First of all, I'd like to thank all of you. I'd like to thank all of you for your support for this change. Begin with Sarawak, Impian Sarawak fundraising dinner. Thank you very much. Your support means a lot to us, and your support will motivate us to work harder to bring a change to Malaysia. And with the strong support that I see tonight, the organizer told me that within less than three weeks, we managed to sell more than 100 tables. With this kind of strong support, I would also like to tell our Prime Minister Najib Tun Razak and also Tun Mahathir that we are not alone. DAP is not alone. You think only Tun Mahathir and Najib is not alone? We DAP also not alone. Agree or not? 各位今晚出席今天这个筹款晚宴的朋友们、来宾们，首先我要感谢你们给予这一场这个沙捞越之梦 Impian Sarawak 筹款晚宴那么大力的支持，你们的鼎力的支持给予我们很大的鼓舞，也鼓励我们更加努力、更加用心的去向前冲，去努力来改革马来西亚，以便我们的马来西亚能够成为一个更加美好的马来西亚，让我们的孩子有个更加美好的未来。谢谢你们，谢谢你们。最重要的是，从今晚我看到大家那么踊跃的支持，让我很想大声的告诉我们的首相纳吉，以及告诉我们的前首相敦马哈蒂，我们也不孤单啊。不只是马哈蒂他不孤单，不只是纳吉不孤单，我们民主行动党也一样不孤单，因为我们有这么多的支持者，从不中的、苏邦的、UHA 的，通通今晚都来到这边支持我们的这一场筹款晚宴，谢谢你们，谢谢。Every single dollar, every single ringgit.That you donated for this Impian Sarawak dinner will not be used for political purpose, and it will not go into the Chong Chien Ren pocket. And every ringgit that we collected for this fundraising, we will make sure it will be used for to improve the living standard for the native in the villages in Sarawak. So every single dollar.We will make sure that we will use it to upgrade, to help the native to get the clean water for drinking. And we help them to build the road. We also help them to repair a bridge. And we even go to the extent to have the tuition class to make sure all the children from the villages to have the education. And few months ago, we also started another program. We help the native to open up the business.We teach them how to run a small grocery store to help them to earn their own living. So this is what we have done. But with the money alone, with the donation that we collected alone, it will not be enough. We also need a lot of manpower. And I also understand that tonight we have about 60 of the Impian Sarawak volunteers are here. Where are the volunteers from Impian Sarawak? Oh, they are sitting there. Ladies and gentlemen, those are the volunteers.For Impian Sarawak. These volunteers, they all are not paid. All free, all percuma. They are not paid. They are not paid doesn't mean that they are worthless. But because they are priceless, can we give a big round of applause to all the volunteers for Impian Sarawak?各位来宾们，今晚你们所捐献的这个每一块钱每一零几给予这一个沙捞越之梦的这一个基金，我们将会确保我们所收到的每一块钱每一分钱将会用在如何去提升我们的这个沙捞越土著朋友他们的生活水准。在这几年来， 我们利用我们所收到的这所筹到的这些基金呢，我们帮他们提供，就是帮他们拿到了这个干净的食水，至少他们有一个干净的水喝。然后我们也帮助他们修路，我们帮助他们大桥建新的桥，我们也甚至开了补习班，我们开补习班教他们的这些小孩子，我们要确保沙捞越这些土族朋友的小孩子们，他们能够受到教育，所以教育是一个很重要的。我们甚至在几个月之前，我们也开始了另外一个计划，我们更进一步，我们在教导这些我们的土族朋友如何经商。我们教他们开一间小小的这个杂货店，让他们来能够赚一点点小小的这个盈利，让他们每个月能够有一些钱。所以这个是我们 Impian Sarawak 一直在做住的东西。但是单单有钱也是不足够，假如没有人力，我们就有钱还是不足够。你们可以看到今天我们有一堆，就是这个大概60位左右 Impian Sarawak 的义务工作者，他们有和我们一起来出席今晚的这一个晚宴。所以没有他们，我们也是办不到事。我们再给他们一个热烈的掌声好不好？这些都是义务的助理。On the 31st of March, our Prime Minister Najib Tun Razak went all the way to Sarawak for a launching of the Pan Borneo Highway. And on the same day, he also announced that this highway will be a toll-free highway. Pan Borneo Highway will be a toll-free highway. I welcome this announcement. And from the announcement from Najib Tun Razak,there's one very important message that who said government cannot build a toll-free highway? And who said government cannot build a highway without toll? When Malaysian national government proposed to build KEDEX from Kinara to Damansara Utama, there will be a toll for KEDEX. But for those live in Puchong, if they want to travel to Damansara Utama, where is the alternative? There's no alternative route from Puchong to Damansara Utama. You need to pay toll, LDP. For those who came all the way from Puchong to one city, to this dinner here, you need to pay RM1.60 toll at Puchong Barat toll, LDP Puchong Barat toll. Where is the alternative for Puchong folks who come to one city? None. And then in such circumstances,how come Barisan Nasional can sign the agreement with LDP in 1988 to have the toll in Puchong Barat? Where is the alternative? No alternative. So, 各位嘉宾们，我刚刚说到呢，那吉他在3月31号的时候去到这个沙捞越，去沙捞越他做了一项宣布，他去那边出席了一场这个推介礼，就是这个泛婆罗洲大道的一个推介里，他下边推介了这个 highway。 在同时呢，他也宣布这条 highway 将是一个免收费的大道，这条 highway 你用是免费的。我非常欢迎拿进了这一项宣布，泛婆罗洲大道是一条免费的大道。由此可见，由拿进的这个宣布可见，虽说政府不能建一条免收费的大道，谁说政府不能建 highway 不用收费站的大道？以前我们一直听到国政政府说不可能的啦，但是现在那就在沙捞越宣布了。当然这个是很好的措施。现在我们看回这个KEDEX， 这个 KEDEX 大道， KEDEX 大道当他们宣布他们有这个意愿要建 KEDEX 大道，以疏散这个补种到Damansara Utama的交通的时候，这条大道是有收费站的，是有toll的。但是我们补种要去到 Damansara Utama， 我们没有替代的公路，我们唯一可以用的就是 LDP。 包括今晚如果各位从补种的朋友要来到这个湾 City 来出席支持我们的这一场沙捞越之梦的晚宴，我们也是要在Puchong Barat那边给个快6000的toll才能来到这一边。我们哪里有替代公路从补种来到这个湾 City？ 在这样的情况下，为什么这个国政政府能在1988年的时候以 LDP 签署了一个38年的合约来收这个过路费，让补种的人民来 One City 来 USJ 这一带都要给这个收入过路费。令我们更加担心的另外一件事，就是在38年，当这个 agreement， 当这个和大道的合约到期了之后，会不会像巴杜第一个的那个收费站再延迟20年啊？ What is worrying us is after 38 years of the contract with LDP, where LDP get the extension of another 20 years toll collection like Batu Tiga. 所以这个是让我们更加担心的。这个也是其中一个最主要的原因，为什么我身为这个埔总金銮旗的族议员，我们要反对这个 KEDEX 大道的建设。因为我们不懂 KEDEX 大道的内容，它的合约的内容，我们不懂它要收多少年，我们也不懂它要收多少钱，所以我不能看埔总的子民们、埔总的人民们世世代代子子孙孙受这个大道公司的欺压，所以我们一定要拒绝 KEDEX 大道，这个就是埔总的主要的原因。哪里有这样的理由，人民受大道公司子子孙孙世世代代的欺压，然后那些乌统的本党公司的子子孙孙就坐在那边翘脚，每天在那边收钱，对吗？ So we cannot allow this kind of situation to happen. We cannot the endless toll collection to happen in everywhere in our country. Take KEDEX as an example. As an adun for Kinara Puchong, I cannot allow my friend or my constituents in Puchong to suffer generation after generation for the endless toll collection and the unknown rate that they're going to impose, because we haven't seen the contract. We do not know. So this is one of the main reasons why I must oppose KEDEX Highway. Ladies and gentlemen, after the implementation of the GST, everywhere we go now, we are hear a lot of complaints. We go to coffee shop, we go to hardware shop, we go to grocery, we go to pharmacy, everywhere we go, we are hear the business operator complaining that the entire implementation of the GST is in a mess. I'm sure tonight we have a lot of businessmen and business operators are together with us. I think everybody agree that it is in a mess. Correct or not? The implementation of GST. I just give you one example. Before the implementation of GST, government announced that for the small business retailer, if you are not ready to invest or you can't afford to invest so much money for the computerized GST system, or you do not know how to use a computer, simple, government have the solution for you. You can use a pre-printed tax invoice provided all the information including your GST number is printed on the pre-printed tax invoice. This is an announcement from the government. But 2 weeks after the implementation of GST, the director of GST from Customs Department, Dato Subramaniam, he announced that the pre-printed tax invoice can only be used until the end of the month. Until end of April. Subsequently, few days later, son of Chua Shui Lek, Chua Junior, he made another announcement. He said all the pre-printed invoice will be accepted until September this year. Few days later, Chua Junior further announced that only 5 industries allowed to use a pre-printed tax invoice. Within 2 weeks, 3 different kind of announcements. How do you want the business operator, how do you want the business community to adapt to this kind of messy system? Why can't government just appoint one official spokesperson for all the new policy of GST? And the best person to announce all the new policy will be the finance minister. And so happened that our finance minister is our prime minister. Dan juga digelar sebagai bapa GST, betul tak? So Najib Tun Razak is the best person to announce all the new policies because he's a bapa GST. He should know the best what the government wants. And the business community, in fact, are helping. All the operators are helping the government to collect the taxes. They should be rewarded. Not by giving this kind of troubles, not by giving this kind of problem to all the business communities. 我刚刚说到呢，在这个四月一号的时候，也就是愚人节，国政政府呢向马来西亚的人民开了一个没有 U 转、没有的回头的这一个大玩笑，那就是开始在全马各地实行 GST 消费税的这个制度。啊 ，OK， 啊，好，我就因为我们的这个首席部长呢要赶飞机，我就长话短说。所以呢，在这个制度之下呢，引起了很多混乱。我们去到哪里，所有的这些商家都会向我们 complain 说，很乱，政府在乱，我们商家怎么不乱？政府只要一天没有把这个制度拟定好，我们大家都在乱。所以呢，这个所有 GST 的这个新的这些制度，我觉得我们就需要由一位正式的官方的人士来做出宣布，而不是今天由这个小蔡宣布，明天又由另外一个人宣布。你要商家如何去适从？无所适从啊！对于这个 GST 的这个制度，所以呢，最适合的人选就是我们的财政部长，也就是我们的首相，因为他也是我们的 GST 之父。就是由首相宣布所有 GST 的这个policy 将会是最恰当的。但是如果我们全部人今天这边有没有本马当包的写名，如果这边本马当包的写名，还是你们有朋友是本马当包的写名，记得告诉他们，利用你们手中的一票，利用你们手中一票告诉纳吉，告诉这个国政，我们不要 GST，好不好？我们要确保高岸旺姐在本邦担保赢得，甚至比上一届安华赢得更加漂亮，好不好 ？With that, I end my speech. Thank you very much. 谢谢大家，谢谢。